the admin out of the way, which is the thank yous. First of all, thank you all for coming this evening.
You're welcome.
I know most of you, all of you, apart from Rose, no, I've lost them, have come a very, very long way tonight. So I really, really appreciate that. So that really reflects what we all think of Zena this evening, which is basically a free thing.
That's true.
But it's true.
Too low. But actually true.
but there is a really big thank you I have to say, first of all, Sarah.
Yay!
None of this evening would be happening. So Sarah, thank you so much for this evening. So now we move on. Firstly, Gruppenführer Zena, the Grammar Nazi of all speeches, hasn't seen sight or sound of this speech. Oh, thank God. There are so many grammar spelling mistakes. I'm absolutely loving it because I have not had to run this faster. So, as ever, I'm running off sketch. On to birthdays. Let's be honest, by the time you've had over 40 of them, there should be some sort of restriction or, you know, restraining order against them. I mean, after 40, by the time it gets to midnight, you've had a few your favourite poisons, your body's going in and it's going to make you pay the next day. It's making you feel older than you already am, and begging God that just take it away, just make it go away. So adding to the pain the whole process. But birthdays themselves are not unusual. Everybody has them. They're always at the same point each year, once a year, unless you're the Queen, of course, which is. I can see you. Unless you're the Queen, of course, who has two a year, which I've never really got. Anyway, they happen no matter you want them or not. So believe me, I've had quite a few, and looking around this room, So why are we here? Well, it's not to celebrate the inevitable passing of time, but something much, much, much more. Everyone has birthdays, but everyone is not my wife, thank God. My friend, partner in crime, Zena. Zena, are you all completely unique? This evening is
good.
Yeah.
Good way.
I can feel the embarrassment raging through your body even as we speak. And to be honest, if we were connected to the national grid right now, we could probably power Cobham for a minute. So, okay, you've reached that magical milestone of 15.
Not yet, she hasn't.
That's a whole lot of living, partying, and cake eating. But, and it's a huge but, you don't look that. It's not only that you have the legs of a Moulin Rouge dancer, or a day, look a day over,
28.
Undetermined date to be late to the side. It's because you are a total whirlwind, a whirlwind of love, passion, and enthusiasm. Totally contagious. For me, tonight is a chance to say publicly that I feel so fortunate and honoured to have you not only as my wife, but also as my best friend.
Aww. Did you get that off a birthday card?
Along with your tremendous love and support, you've brought, by example, immense joy into my life. It's not only for me that you do this, but for everyone around you. You care for all.
Yes. Always
looking out for those of your friends and family, Especially those with four legs and fur.
Especially.
That would explain the socks.
Yeah, it would actually. You always have my back, even when you've told me to keep my back and the rest of my body out of trouble. Don't do anything stupid. Try and read the instructions. Slow down. Are you sure you want to do that? It's going to hurt. I can't look. You're always there to pick up the pieces, sometimes quite literally. No one ever said living with me would be easy.
Or a
That is very, very true. Many, many, many thanks for all that you do. You live by the motto of giving everything to everyone and expect nothing in return. I don't think there is a more thoughtful or generous person I've ever known. For everyone that knows you, loves you, you are a resourceful, health nut, devoted friend and family, overall, whom you fuss over so much and spoil and most definitely overfeed. Even the deep stuff isn't that bad. So can I please ask you to raise your glasses to our birthday girl on her second 25th birthday?
Zena!
That's it, thank Christ!
Oh, I forgot the flash.
That's your story of the night.
Sort the girls out.
You're so pretty.
I feel like I probably should have prepared something, but I haven't. As those of you who arrived first probably realise, I have been a bit speechless through most of this evening. Which doesn't happen very often.
No,
very much chatterbox. I'm looking around and people from way back and way close, but all close. I'm just overwhelmed that you're all here, and it's very kind of you.
That's very kind of you. Well, him.
I'm not given to speeches, in case you hadn't realised that. Everyone in this room is very important. Very special people from lots and lots of different little areas of my life, because, as Paul and I were talking about recently, I've got so many different areas of different times and different interests, and somehow I managed to gather people together throw people together that probably would never be in the same room at the same time. But you're all here for a reason, because you're very special. Sarah.
No, we're here because you're special, girl.
Yeah.
We've
Paul, that's a tenner later on, all right?
20?
Yeah, right.
Sarah has absolutely worked her arse off. I'm not entirely sure what I've done to deserve that, but thank you. Maybe now I'm not a woman of many words, but thank you. Every one of you here is very special to me, and I'm really grateful for you being here. Thank you. I don't have any words tonight. It's very unusual. I don't know what to say.
Oh, goodness, my Janet. It's my sister, if anybody didn't know.
So, I'm older, so he has to obey.
Can I just say the only actual family who's bothered to turn up?
She pulled my hair out of shape.
I just would really about half a dozen words. Thank you, Zena, for making my brother such a happy person.
Oh, yeah.
Not easy.
And it's off our hands.
I've known him longer than any of you. And that's very true. Thank you.
Right, first I'm
time I saw Zena was when I was 11, and it was life changing. She was the one that found Dad the pure love and happiness, and then she got to know me very well as well. And since then, it's been really good the past 10 years since I first saw you, Zena. You're a great stepmother.
And then we get to sing, sing, happy birthday to Zena.
So glad you've got the knife, I have to say.
Right.
Thanks, and her name's not Job.
If only they're with all that.
Basically, just plunge the knife into the cake and that's it.
Deep and hard, and just go all the way down.
Oh, yeah. She's done that before, hasn't she?
Oh, very delicate, very delicate.
We're gonna make it. Cheers.